You're now rocking one-on-one with Raider Mystic.
K-P-O-V.
One-on-one with Raider Mystic. Yay!
To me, there are three things we all should do every day. If we do this every day of our life, you're going to have, what a wonderful, number one is laugh. You should laugh every day. Number two is think. You should spend some time in thought. And number three is you should have your emotions moved to tears. Could be happiness or joy. But think about it. If you laugh, you think, and you cry, that's a full day. That's a heck of a day. You do that 7 days a week, you're going to have something special.
You want sports content that you've never heard in your entire life? Check me out every Saturday morning from 8 a.m. to 9 a.m.
It's one-on-one with Raider Mystic.
We sit down, we have a cup of coffee, and we break it down for 60 minutes one-on-one with a sports athlete. Traverse the universe with me of sports as we interview all walks of life. We are just getting started. The only sports talk show in Central Oregon. I'm your guy.
It's one-on-one with Raider Mystic.
Willard, long range three, and it's good! At the buzzer! Damian Willard! Are you kidding me?
One-on-one, go Giants!
Well, I've been selling my soul, working all day, overtime hours for bullshit pay, so I can sit out here and waste my life away, drag back home and drown my troubles away. It's a damn shame what the world's gotten to for people like me, people like you. Wish I could just wake up and it not be true, but it is. Oh, it is. Living in the new world with the old soul. These rich men north or rich men, Lord knows it all. Just wanna have total control. Wanna know what you think. Wanna know what you do. And they don't think you know, but I know that you do. Cause your dollar ain't this shit, and it's taxed to no end. Cause the rich men, cause the rich men. I wish politicians would look out for miners, and not just miners on an island somewhere. Lord, we got folks in the street, ain't got nothing to eat, and the whole beast milking welfare. Well, God, if you're 5'3" and you're 300 pounds, taxes ought not to pay for your bags of fudge rounds. Young men are putting themselves 6 feet in the ground, cause all this damn country does is keep on kicking them down. Lord, it's a damn shame what the world's gotten to for people like me, people like you. Wish I could just wake up and it not be true, but it is. Oh, it is. Living in the new world with an old soul. These rich men know the rich men, Lord knows they all just wanna have total control. Wanna know what you think, wanna know what you do, and they don't think you know, but I know that you do. Cause your dollar ain't this, and it's taxed to no end. Cause the rich men know the rich men. Overtime hours for bullish pay.
Yes, sir. Thanks for joining me this morning. I'm Raider Mystic. This is One on One. And yeah, that's a great track. A new artist by the name of Oliver Anthony just popped out of nowhere. I mean, like literally popped out of the woods. With just this little video of himself singing in the woods on his property, living out of like a $500 trailer, I'll give you a little background, a little history if you don't know. Most people already know about this, but, you know, some people don't do any research on all these breaking stories. But, yeah, you know, as far as politics go, people might claim he's one side or the other, but if you listen to him in his own interviews, he is his truly own independent art form that is just kind of anti-establishment. But I appreciate that song. It's very soulful, but you have not heard a song that came out of nowhere and just blasted past everybody on the charts to become number one on the Billboard in like a week. Like, you never heard of this artist. I mean, he's just got his guitar. The recording that's released is actually him outside on his property, and that's the version that they put out, and it skyrockets past everything. Taylor Swift goes down in a ball of flames. The Swifties got the lifties and went down. He passed Ed Sheeran. He passed everybody. All the crappy trap rap. He blew past it all. And he shot up to number one in the world on YouTube also. It's an amazing story. Kudos, Oliver Anthony. I know he's got some more revolutionary music that he's releasing. But at the same time that he like blew up, he kind of dipped, and he's just not saying much because he doesn't really want that. So that's all I got on that. Always love a good song, you know, good song to get you going at the beginning of the day. Anyways, it's Saturday morning. It's 8:08 if you're on Hawaiian time. That's the area code over there, 808. Man, shout out to my people in Maui. I hope y'all hanging in there. I know we've had some crazy times, fires, and it's beautiful to see this rainy weather approaching us here. And it is insane, as it always is in Central Oregon. You know, you're experiencing like all this heat, smoke. And then one night, it all just changes. And you're like, I kind of wanted a little bit more heat, but we just got instant like fall. Didn't have a clicker that we could just be like, hey, let's get like 75. Well, maybe that's coming this next week. That's what it looks like. You know, Bob Shaw's not around to tell me. But the fake Bob Shaw said next week, man, we might hit those mids again with some sunshine, and that would be nice. I know that fire, Pete's Lake fire up 5 miles west, I believe, of Elk Lake is 0% contained. That's a 0%. But hopefully with these conditions and the rain and the drizzle, that it's putting it down, getting it out. And that's all I got. That's your breaking music update, and that's your weather for the week. And we got a lot of things that have happened in the last week, let me tell you. I got a special guest. We're going to check in at halfway through the hour and check in with the buddy that went to an Oakland A's game last night down there in the Oak Town. 357, too short, I see you, MC Hammer. I was at a Raider game where I was walking side by side with Hammer in the parking lot. Man, that's some classic stuff right there. But we got, as promised, I got high school football updates. We're going to get into it all. We're going to get you, you know, more high school sports too. I know volleyball's happening. I know soccer's popping. It's good to see. I pulled up to the Mountain View Camby 5A junior varsity game the other night. I saw the soccer field was full. I saw fans out there. And it's kind of crazy. I wonder at what point we started playing sports before school actually starts, like the first game of the season, is played without even, you know, if you just move to town and you don't know anybody, like, do you know that there's actually a football game that's going on? I don't know. But I'm sure the schools do a pretty good job at trying to relay all that information. But at the same time, they are relaying so much information, you know. I know the same time that we had the JV football game was also the orientation for the kids at the elementary school. So juggling. But we're doing it. We're doing it all. And a lot going on in the sports world. We're getting there. High school sports. Let's pull it up here, guys. I want to get you the updates on what happened last night. And, you know, if you know any of these high school football coaches, you got to get them to get on the OSAA.org website and update their football scores. If they're the ones responsible for updating their football scores, they need to get on there. I know sometimes when you lose, it takes it might take an extra 24 hours to log in and update, or if it's the athletic directors, or the ADs are supposed to be updating. I don't know who's in charge of that, but when I woke up this morning and all excited to get all of these football scores for you, I realized that, like, 25% of these coaches or ADs or whoever's supposed to be updating these scores did not update the score. So I'm watching. We are watching. We want to know where we are at, what the scores are, all that, because our kids are involved in all of this stuff. But a lot of action. I'm gonna just give you the 6A. I know we're not in 6A, but actually Summit played a 6A team last night. So Tualatin came over for that one. But I'm going to give you the 6A scores here. We got Lake Oswego and Barlow. Lake Oswego took down Barlow 40-22. Sherwood beat West Salem 34-21. Mililani, Hawaii at Sheldon. I don't know how that one happened. We'll have to research that. 37-3. They got whooped. Cleveland over Park Rose 28-22. South Eugene beat McDaniel 20-2. There was a couple teams last night that only got two. David Douglas, we know some people there. 12-7 over Aloha. And Clackamas beat Westview 28-7. Roseburg over Beaverton 50-18. Grants Pass over Del Norte 20-6. And here's one that locally happened. It was Tualatin and Summit. And Summit starts off with a loss. Tualatin beat Summit 42-14. South Medford 42, Mountainside 28. Franklin 28, Gresham 27. I'm going to kind of stall there because we got a lot of teams right there. But, yeah, so Summit had Tualatin come here for their season opener. And Tualatin's 6A. So, you know, as far as how these games get set up, I believe sometimes, you know, we have the option of scheduling some of this stuff. So, sounds like they wanted to get Tualatin over here. Well, they got Tualatin over here, and they got Tualatized. You know what I'm saying? So, Summit starts out 0-1 with a loss to Tualatin. And let's go to our division here for our Bend schools, which is 5A. So we got McKay beating Lebanon, 31-28. Crescent Valley over Woodburn, 27-12. South Albany defeated Central, 41-6. West Albany defeated Corvallis, 42-12. Silverton over Dallas, 34-7. Marist Catholic over Churchill in an overtime thriller, 36-35. Southridge over Centennial, 27-14. Ashland beat Eagle Point in a Southern Oregon battle, 35-21. Redmond, here you are. Redmond got Hood River Valley. They blanked him, gave him an egg. Redmond won that one 19-0. So big win for Redmond for their kickoff game. Springfield got Ridgeview, but Ridgeview's putting up some points. That's good to see. I know they're on the climb. Springfield 39, Ridgeview 21. Know some of those coaches over there. Wilsonville defeated Thurston 44-15. Pendleton defeated Caldera. So this was Caldera's first full varsity team. Got defeated by Pendleton 27-20. And so Caldera starts out the season 0-1. And the game that I watched last night, because I am associated with children there, is Mountain View defeats Canby 49-20. So that game was a tale of two halves. Mountain View was down at halftime with, I believe it was about three unanswered touchdowns going in to halftime with some extracurricular stuff going on in that game too. Got a little hot, got a little heated. Some flags. Coach was ejected. I don't know what was going on there, but it seemed to fire up the troops. And when we came back for the second half, 35 unanswered points against Canby. And if you don't know about the running back Angel from Mountain View, you're going to find out soon, man. He's running people over. Watch out. I like what I see. I like what I see. It looks like a good little setup. And the defense, there was a major fourth down hold. It was fourth and one at the one. And they stopped Canby right then and there, shut him down. And then the very first play from the 1 yard line, hand off to Angel. He runs 85 yards, almost goes the distance, but strong runner, and he runs people over. So nice to see, but get out of his way, get out of his way. So yeah, some promise there for Mountain View. Good win for them. And then let's go down to Crook County. Crook County in the 4A. Crook County 22, Philomath 13. So Crook County starts out with a big win. Congratulations, Crook County. Good to see you guys doing your thing. I know Lapine had it a little tougher. I saw the score. They got the egg. The Dalles had 27. Lapine with zero on that one. So they're going to be looking to bounce back right there. Who else we got? I know Ben High was out here. Ben High got a big win to start out the season too. So let's pull them up here. Ben, where you at? My alma mater. I am a lava bear. If you don't know, I was back in the day. Bend defeated Lincoln 20-0. And we got the top three plays on Z21. A little shout out, NBC, where you at? But the top three plays they got that you can vote for is a jump ball for the tight end from Summit, Charlie Crowell, or Michael Picard with a touchdown run from Madras, which we're about to get into, or Wyatt McLean from Bend High with a 72-yard touchdown run. Now, Wyatt McLean, on your 72-yard touchdown run, that was fast. That was fire. Congratulations. You got some speed. So watch out for Wyatt for Bend High. We got you on the radar. And this kid, though, over at Madras, Michael Picard, he had a couple touchdown runs or a couple couple big runs. He had a 75-yard run also, where he looked pretty good. So watch out for him over in Madras. I know he's going to be tearing it up. And trust me when I tell you, I know what I know. I see talent when I see talent. I grew up watching Napoleon Kaufman run in high school, and I've never seen anybody run quite like him. Anytime I see a kid with some quick little legs, it always brings up some deja vus, some past incidences. And let's continue on. We got Sisters in our area. Sisters defeated Burns 19-13. So Sisters is on the map with a win. So yeah, we got Mountain View and Bend getting the wins locally. And Sisters also, Crook County. And we had Lapine, Summit, and Caldera falling with the L's. But that's just the first week, and I expect everyone to have a bounce back for sure. So we'll keep you updated with these high school scores. We'll start getting some of these athletes in here too, speaking with them. It's been quite a busy summer in my world, but I'm on the bounce back, and here we go. There's been a lot going on in the sports world. We got the NFL season coming up too. I'm going to talk to my guy John here in about 8 minutes or so. And, you know, we had another one of our great musicians that we love, everyone loves, a lot of people love, pass away, as we seem to every few weeks, it seems. But shout out Jimmy Buffett. Jimmy Buffett, some of you probably don't even know yet, but he just passed away yesterday. Jimmy Buffett was a big part of my life growing up as well. And he just passed on. So in order to give him a little shout out here, what I'm going to do is play a track by Jimmy Buffett here. This is actually a track he sang about Labor Day weekend, and you know what it is. It is Labor Day weekend. So we'll get into this, and then I'll come back with some more sports talk. Let's go.
Come Monday. Thank you very much. One of my 2.4 hit records. We had no money to do this video. Thus, I had my girlfriend at the time, Jane, work for free. She had been modeling. She now is my wife. She doesn't work for free anymore. The car is not a prop. That was my truck and my Conk Cruiser until it was impounded and crushed into a scrap metal rectangle at Carlos's junkyard. The Boston Whaler was my first boat that I ever bought. There really wasn't much need in scripting this. This was where I lived, the people I lived with, and the girl who I wrote Come Monday about. So here it is.
Heading out to San Francisco for the Labor Day weekend show. I got my hush puppies on. I guess I never was meant for glitter rock and roll. And honey, I didn't know that I'd be missing you so. Come Monday, it'll be alright. Come Monday, I'll be holding you tight. I spent four lonely days in a brown early haze, and I just want you back by my side. Yes, it's been quite a summer. Rent a cars and westbound trains, and now you're off on vacation. Something you tried to explain. And darling, it's I love you so. That's the reason I just let you go. Come Monday, it'll be alright. Come me holding you tight. I spent four lonely days in a brown LA haze, and I just want you back by my side. I can't help it, honey, you're that much a part of me now. Remember that night in Montana when we said there'd be no room for doubt? I hope you're enjoying the scenery. I know that it's pretty up there. We can go hiking on Tuesday. With you I'd walk anywhere. California has worn me quite thin. I just can't wait to see you again. Come Monday, it'll be alright. Come Monday, I'll be holding you tight. I spent four lonely days in a brown LA haze, and I just want you back by my side. I spent four lonely days in a brown LA haze, and I just want you back by my side.
Rest in peace, Jimmy. Classic track, Labor Day weekend. And in that music video, it's his own little two-person boat. It's his own little classic summer truck. And it's his girlfriend that becomes his wife. Classic stuff right there, man. Classic stuff. You can't make it up. Can't make it up. Really unique. You know, going back in my history, I would say Jimmy Buffett is actually in one of my top couple concerts that I, the first few that I saw. I wasn't going to say it was like my, it's not my top five for me personally of watching, but it's in my top five of the first five I've ever been to. I would have to say the first concert I ever saw was Jan and Dean at Bend High School. That's the first concert I remember, is dancing on stage with Jan and Dean at Bend High School. They don't do that kind of stuff anymore, do they? And then the next concert I was at was, I believe it's going to be, yeah, it's going to be Jimmy Buffett at the Santa Barbara Bowl. I believe that's correct. And then after that, my next concert is going to be, my mom took me to go see MC Hammer in Portland. It was MC Hammer, Boyz II Men, Jodeci, and TLC. And that was an epic one too. So if you're out there listening, Mom, thanks for helping me get to my MC Hammer show. It might have changed my life. MC Hammer at the time had three full drum set drummers too. You know, I've never seen that in a rap show ever since then, or I never thought I would even see a live drummer, but he had three full drum kits. He was doing it big. So we are going to give my guy John. John is down in the Bay Area. We're going to check in. We're going to check in on the Bay, from the Bay to LA to Las Vegas, and see what's going on down there and what the vibe is. So let's pull out the call, the old phone, Skarooskies. I can just make up words. That's what I do. That's what we do as freestyle artists. Here we go. We're calling him live on the air. Who else does this? I don't know.
Hey, this is John.
Hey, John. Hey, John.
Hey, good morning. Good morning. Hey, that stuff about Jimmy Buffett, that was beautiful. What a perfect time, if there has to be perfection in a situation like this. That was just it's a perfect time, perfect weekend to play that song. I wasn't ready. I just want you to know, I wasn't ready.
Yeah.
But you know, rest in peace, Jimmy Buffett.
Yeah, you know, I grew up, as I was saying, you know, I grew up, my dad was a big Jimmy fan, and I know a few parrot heads, right?
yeah, I think I'm married to one as far as that goes, but kind of a moment of silence, you know, today, this weekend.
Yeah, I wasn't even aware until I got up in here this morning, and yep, there's always something, you know, it's always somebody, and we got so many major influences that have kind of shaped us and been big parts of our music history that, yeah, they're getting older, and it's happening.
Yeah, that is well said. That's well said. And with that, I'm going to hope Rick Springfield's got a couple more weeks in him. if you pick up what I'm putting down. So
if you know, you know. And if you don't, you don't. But let's talk about where you're at. Where are you at right now?
As I speak to you, we are doing a live remote for KPOV from the, I think it's the north end zone of Spartan Stadium here in San Jose, California, amongst the palm trees.
Nice.
And the freshly painted goalposts and the TV crews working hard. I'm having to find a place here where the blowers aren't going because they're blowing all the dust away from the summer to get ready for Oregon State, San Jose State tomorrow.
Oh, is that why you're down there?
Yeah, a rare Sunday matchup.
Ooh, that is kind of different, huh?
It is different. I've had it on my radar a couple years because I like the Bay Area, as you know, and we're going to hear a little more about another pilgrimage we made yesterday while we were down here in the Bay. And so, you know, I'd like to say Pac-12 versus Mountain West, we would come in here kind of as big shots normally.
Mm-hmm.
That's not really the case right now. I think I'm going to be walking around here tomorrow going, can we please join your league? it's the strangest situation. I don't know what to say about it. Probably just shouldn't say anything about it because OSU and Wazoo are the last two standing. They're not really standing. I think they're kind of buckling from a gut punch right now. And we're down here in San Jose going, wouldn't it be nice to have a conference next year? So
wouldn't it be nice?
Yeah. Hey, maybe we're going to come here every other year going forward. So maybe I have to get used to this.
Hey.
But they do have a beautiful stadium here. They just revamped like half of it, much like the Beavers did up in Corvallis last year. They kind of rebuilt half their stadium here, and it's, you know, looks really cool. So we just got to get the W down here.
Is the Beaver Stadium ready to go yet? Do we know?
Yeah. It's they're playing, you know, next week. They got one of the preseason cupcakes coming in up there, and it's going to be ready to go next week. But they're on the road. They're road Beavers right now, and going to play tomorrow.
Yeah. So yeah, I was at a couple games last year, and it was like what, one half of the side of the stadium you couldn't sit in.
But we still were bringing the noise and had a great season despite the, you know, the low capacity. But they got it squared away now. Spent $160 million, so that's really good, just in time to have our revenue stream completely axed by the dissolution of the Pac-12 conference. But hey, there's got to be a silver lining somewhere.
Yeah. Hey, didn't you beat the Ducks last year?
Yes, beat them soundly.
Ooh, soundly.
Had them right where we wanted the entire game, and that ended up to be the case when the final whistle blew.
Yeah, that counts that makes the whole season good, I think.
But yeah, and you know, we should put out there over the airwaves that makes it two out of the last three for the Beavs.
Ooh, two out of three.
Enjoy the Big Ten and Oregon, and having Ohio State come in and eat your lunch. Enjoy all that. Michigan, you name it.
Yeah. So, yeah, college football is firing up.
Yes. Today's the big official day, but you know what? There's been a few games here, like Thursday, Friday, Couple games going on, but today is the big day, and I think U of O actually is playing. They're playing PSU today over at over at Eugene, and it's nice to have them kick Portland State a few $100,000 to keep their doors open. So I will thank the Ducks for doing that, and Phil Knight. Yep.
Yeah, that's nice. That's nice of them. So
yeah.
So yeah, you just did something that I kind of had deja vu with, because I did that. I was in the Bay Area, and I was like, huh, you know, is there any baseball games tonight?
Oh yeah.
And I was like, oh, I heard I could go to an A's game for like $10. And how much? So you went to the A's game last night.
Yeah. Hey, thanks to the internet and everything being online now, the A's put out a deal, you know, for the season, where on a Friday night, if you pay $50, you get four tickets plus parking.
Woo!
And I think the parking alone was $30. So screaming deal works out to about $5 a ticket.
Yeah, that's crazy.
And we invaded the parking lots, which were relatively empty at the Oakland Coliseum. But you know what, man? It is still standing there in all its majesty. Mount Davis is, alive and well. It's got a big green tarp all over it.
Yeah.
But we enjoyed the heck out of it. It was a great evening. It wasn't as cold as everybody thought it was going to be. And Shohei Ohtani was coming in. Well, of course, a week ago he gets hurt, so he's not going to pitch. But he still batted, and I think he went like 1-for-4, 1-for-5 last night, something like that.
Okay.
And stirred up the crowd a little bit when he would come to bat. And I saw they had 12,000 for the game. So I think that's about 2 or 3 times as big as the normal A's crowd this year.
Oh, yeah. I went and checked. Sorry. Yeah.
Well, Friday night, Shohei Ohtani, that probably made the difference.
Yeah, I went and checked the standings just to make sure I knew what I was talking about. And it looks like the A's are kind of still where they've been for a while.
right in the leaking sewage in the
trash can. Yeah.
But hey, I don't go down that low in the Coliseum. I'm not down there in the dugouts or in the locker rooms. We stay up.
Yeah,
in those higher decks, and just enjoy the beautiful view, the field. They always say the Oakland A's have one of the best fields in baseball, and I think that still looks to be the case. The field was just immaculate. A's fans are very passionate. I can't believe, considering how crappy they are, that how many people wear A's gear. They've taken liberty with a lot of the seating sections since the Raiders are gone, and they're, they have a lot of seating sections that are just drink rails where you stand and you have a little kind of table in front of you.
Okay.
That's pretty nice.
Yeah, because they don't have to do that crossover anymore.
Yeah, exactly. And, the ushers, we literally had a couple ushers tell us, yeah, just sit wherever you want.
just
sit wherever you want. So, in that regard,
that's fun.
That's inexpensive fun. Night, and, me and my kid kind of walked up through all the sections and the nooks and crannies of the Oakland Coliseum because I have a lot of nostalgia for it. I'm starting to get choked up, Aaron, because, the history and all that. But
Yeah.
No, it's still there. And maybe next year they're going to play there. I don't know. I think next year is kind of a wild card. But
yeah.
I'm going to say, I'll recommend, if you're down here, go to an A's game. It was kind of fun.
Yeah, aren't they supposed to be moving to Vegas?
Yes, and the thing is, though, that keeps getting
pushed.
Not pushed out, but now they're like, oh, the stadium won't be ready till like 27 or maybe even 28, and they were going to play like in a AAA ballpark over there for, now it's like what? Like 3 seasons? That seems a lot. So
yeah.
I'm not sure where they're going to be. They may have one more year in Oakland, and so go down and see them while you can.
Yeah. Yeah, I had that experience that you're having, like if I felt like 10 years ago. I think it might have been, I don't know, not that long ago, but just that, the the A's were still kind of on the bottom. Tickets were incredibly cheap.
Oh, yeah.
It was a Friday night, but people came out, and they were down, but they had an amazing comeback, and they won that night, and it was a lot of fun. I called up the post-game show.
No.
And I got on. And, you know, they were you know, just continually dissing their own team, but I described how, you know, I was from Oregon. I was there for the evening, and we had the greatest time, and we had a lot of fun. And, you know, don't be so down on yourselves. It was a good experience of professional baseball.
I love it. Yeah, you got to kind of give them a little pep talk there, because were you going to do it that cheap and that easy? And, you know, you kind of have your run of the place because, well, nobody's there, but. It was a good time, and I do want to give a shout out to. It's really weird to look around it and just take a pause and go, wow, this is where all those games, you know, when they had the football layout with Stabler and John Madden and Al Davis down on the sidelines and stuff, yep. All that stuff on NFL films, you're like, wow, this is the place where that all went down for a long time.
Yep.
And, you know, even before they went to LA, and that's pretty, you know, pretty cool.
That place
pretty
is
cool to see.
Electric.
And walking out of the stadium, and by the way, the A's won last night, 9-2, which was kind of cool. They got a lot of runs going. Walking out of the stadium, you still got the vendors selling the hot dogs with the peppers on the bun.
Woo,
and you got
outside
guys selling the kind of bootleg t-shirts outside,
yeah,
including several stacks of Raiders t-shirts. So it was fun to walk out and see that, the tables with the t-shirts and the Raiders.
Still,
wow, it's like the last remnant of what used to be.
Still hustling the Raiders shirts in the tailgate.
Yes. That is really cool. Here it is.
That feels good. That feels good.
Yep.
And yeah, those bacon wrapped hot dogs, right?
Yeah, those are the ones. Yeah, where they pile on the onions and peppers, and
yeah,
they used to have them on the bridge over to Bart. For the A's, they're just right there at the gate where you go in. They don't bother with.
Yeah,
they're just right there.
That was my favorite post-game thing to do right when the game ended. I knew that I could get a couple of those bacon-wrapped hot dogs because they were set up everywhere.
And, my brother, you still can.
And then at that point after the game is when you get the tailgate bootleg shirts, because they have to drop the price because it only has that game that day printed on it. So they had to, you know, they had to sell them for like $5 or so.
So I was so close to getting one that just had the word, it's a green t-shirt, and it just had the word sell on it. That's kind of the, you know, the big phrase down here the last year or two because of the owner. They're trying to get him to sell the team and
So, yeah, I don't understand how this has happened for so long down there. But, you know, ever since Moneyball, one of my favorite movies –
yeah.
And, I mean, they just continue to try to play Moneyball.
it's a sad story.
But they haven't had the wins.
Yeah, right. It got them somewhere to a point, but then, you know, in the long term, I don't know what the hell to say, but, yeah, and you're looking over at the basketball coliseum, which is right next door, and then you think how the Warriors took off.
Mm-hmm.
The Raiders took off. Now the A's are taking off, and you got to have a little empathy for the city of Oakland in that regard, I guess. But
yeah, I mean, Oakland is rich in so many ways. It's unfortunate they couldn't maintain the sports.
Right.
I mean, all the rappers blew up. You got the Two Shorts, the E-40s. You got, you know, Marshawn Lynch coming out of there. You got all these people that, you know, have all risen to a big level, and but we haven't been able to keep the teams there.
Right. Gary Payton, Dame Lillard.
Yep.
Jason Kidd. I think those were all Oakland guys. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know. Well, obviously, I don't know. I'm sad. You mentioned MC Hammer.
Yeah.
I think we can almost see the hills of Fremont where his Titanic house was, where he employed every friend and family member he had for a while.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
Now, did he go broke back then, too?
I'm afraid he did, if I remember my VH1 Behind the Music show.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I mean, yeah. They all got the story, you know. They got big, and then they went broke.
Hey, but, you know, what I did learn, thanks to Facebook posts and shares, is that he had been a bat boy for the A's there at the Coliseum, like, for several years.
Yeah, if you want to connect those dots, yeah, the Oakland A's and MC Hammer, yeah, that was kind of got him into the music scene, was he was a bat boy for the A's, and he danced.
Yeah, isn't that wild? I didn't know that till, like, maybe the last year when I saw it on the old, you know, social media.
And, you know, if you a weird twist to that, in our group, 4Dub, our Raider rap group, Shalif, Mr. Greenleaf, when he started in the group 4Dub way before I was involved in it, and he was just breakdancing with a DJ.
You're kidding. That's what started that.
Yeah, some stuff like that.
That worked out well for all of us. So, you guys have brought us a lot of good... You know, a lot of good music, a lot of good times.
Yeah, man, and we're about to drop album number 8 in like another week or two.
Shut the front door. I did not know that. That's great.
Yep, out great. Of the blue, just when you didn't know, here it is. It's coming soon.
Yeah, hey, good. I'll look forward to it. Look forward to seeing you guys reunite ASAP.
And moving over to that side of the ball, football. NFL football, we got Josh Jacobs coming back. That was a relief, huh?
Yes. Yeah, I have slept better for about a week now, knowing that the attack, despite Josh McDaniels, is going to have a chance of producing some, you know, some points, some wins.
Yeah, the defense is, you know, it's much more solid, I believe. We got Marcus Peters, too, from the Bay.
Very nice.
Cousin of Marshawn Lynch,
know. Oh, yeah, right. Well, that's kind of a legacy hire, so that's good.
Yeah, yeah, the family. Family is in the building. I don't know if you remember the Raiders-Chiefs game, and there was a couple fights that broke out. Marcus Peters was playing for the Chiefs, and Marshawn Lynch ran out to the field to try to help break it up. Or to cool cousin off.
Yeah. I do remember that. That was huge.
I believe Marshawn Lynch got ejected from the game for running out onto the field, but he was just trying to help squash the situation, but people didn't really know what was going on. And so then he's ejected and kicked out of the game. But guess who gets caught on camera later in the crowd?
Did he have his, like, funny nose and glasses? Like,
yeah. No, he didn't have the funny nose, but he had the hoodie on, and he was just watching from the crowd all secretly, like Marshawn Lynch.
I love it. I love it.
He's a funny dude. He was a fun one to have for a couple years.
Yeah, I wish we had. I wish he didn't have that Seahawks taint to him, but I can overlook that.
Yeah. You know, one of my greatest memories. I was hanging out with his mom, right? At the Raiders' home kickoff party in Oakland many years ago when Marshawn was on the team.
Yeah,
and she was wearing his Super Bowl ring that he gave her from the winning the Super Bowl with the Seahawks. And I was wearing, you know, one of my fake Raider Super Bowl rings.
Gotcha.
At the time.
Which I would probably put those at equal worth, in my opinion. But.
And I appreciate the comments. The funniest thing, Marshawn's mom says to me, She's like, yeah, I got this is the real one, but that's the one I want. She wanted the Raiders Super Bowl ring because she is a diehard Raider fan, right?
Probably from right up the road or something.
Right there. She was decked out. She was so happy that Marshawn was a Raider. And I offered to trade her.
Yeah.
And
how'd that go?
It I got a couple laughs. But
she probably needed approval from Marshawn.
Yeah, it didn't work out that time, but it was a cool conversation. Got a couple pictures with her. And you never know who you meet at these season kickoff parties too, man. That was what was nice about Oakland, was just being able to jump in the car and go down there, or be able to survive for a lot cheaper than in Vegas.
That's the whole thing, is you're right, from Bend, it's a doable road trip. There's lots of stuff to do down here, and then you got the games, and at one time had the Raiders, and life was good then.
And in Vegas, I guess we have cheaper flights now that just came back to the Central Oregon area. So anybody trying to get to Vegas can for like $75 now. But it's a certain day that you have to go and back. Yeah. So I'm sure.
Well, one door closes and another one opens.
Right, right. Well, John, I appreciate you coming on the show. Look forward to this NFL getting kicked off also. You have any what's your thoughts on the NFL? Who do you think is going to come out strong?
After watching the quarterback show on Netflix, I'm always entertained by, the Chiefs with Mahomes and Cousins with the Vikings. That was a pretty good show. I think the Chiefs are going to be hard for us to kind of claw into. I hope we keep beating down the Broncos. I'm seeing everything this season through a Raiders lens. although I want to give a shout out to this OSU ball player, Jack Coletto, who was kind of this slash type player for the Beavs the last couple of years.
Mm-hmm.
I believe he's just made the practice squad for the 49ers here, and I think in no time flat, he'll start getting playing time there.
Okay.
And we'll be seeing him on Sundays, I think, even this summer, so that's this fall. So that's what I'm looking forward to for NFL.
Okay. Yeah, I look forward to that very first weekend of football and all the drama that's going to unfold.
Oh, yeah. And I did lay down a bet on the Raiders to win the Super Bowl. I think I got 45-1 odds. That was a couple weeks back in Reno.
Hey, anything is possible. And, actually, that we got a good O-line. We got superstar players in different departments. This team's actually, it's looking pretty good to me.
Drink to that this weekend, okay?
I am feeling good. I don't know how the whole Jimmy G thing, all he has to do is, run the system and not create turnovers.
You know it.
And everything's peachy.
All right. Hey, Lyle. Good luck, brother. Go Beavs.
All right, John.
Hey, give a shout out to a former OSU quarterback down here.
Oh yeah, that was a live quarterback walk by.
That was Lyle Muevo, who led the Beavs to a bowl game or two, a few years back, and a big win over USC. And he is a coach here with San Jose State program. And
okay.
He was just walking by because I think they're all heading from the weight room to the
meetings. I love it. A live shout out. Previous OSU quarterback.
You got it.
Live on the air as we talk.
He probably doesn't even know it, but up here in Oregon, that guy made a lot of Beaver fans happy many times.
Right on. Well, thanks, John. I'm going to sign out. We got a couple minutes left. I have to drop a freestyle, and we'll talk to you soon, okay?
You bet. We are tuned in.
All right. I got you. All right, shout out to John, the notorious J-O-H-N, here in Bend, member of our crew, Bend, Oregon Raider Nation. We're starting the season off. And if you guys know Raider fans, I'm sure you do. We got a new clubhouse, place called Big E's, B-I-G-E, apostrophe S, Biggies. Like Biggie, Biggie, Biggie. And that's where we have the conference room. We'll be watching all the Raider games. We got the football season coming up. A lot of action about to kick off. Thursday night this week is the night. We also got some serious, you're going to be like, what? Tennis action going on. In case you don't know, I have a history of playing some tennis. I was a little more involved back in the day. Played for Bend High, Lava Bear Tennis, Dennis Nielsen, Coach Abby. I had Nielsen for two classes, and he was my coach. And I really had trouble getting along. That was a lot of time. A lot of time with an old school dude. But it all works out in the end. And we got a big week of tennis, though. The U.S. Open is going. I've been watching Coco Gauff with her rise to fame in the last few tennis tournaments. Man, this girl's young. She's got a lot of spirit, a lot of power, and she's moving up the brackets quick. I believe she's ranked number 6 in the world. Before summer started, she wasn't even in the top 50. So she'll be up. I think she plays tomorrow. We got a lot of action on the courts with the U.S. Open. That's some exciting stuff. If you want to watch some good tennis, head over there. And we're going to close out this show. We just got a couple minutes left here. I told some people I'd drop a little freestyle. That's what I do sometimes. So let's freestyle our way out of this, all right? And I'll catch you guys next week. One on one. I got Young Gotti on the beat. Oh no. How'd he do it? How'd I get here? Right live in the studio, transition from sports talk on the telephone. OSU quarterback in a walk by at San Jose live 5 minutes ago. I can't believe it. Is this real? Come on. Come follow me. Come on. Yeah. I said it's Saturday morning, September 2nd, 8:59. You know, MC Mystic in the studio, feeling fine. I'm so divine with this divinity in infinity. Space and time, are you feeling me? You seeing me? I'm right here at KPOV. And I've been breaking down the sports for thee. We had the Lava Bears, had a big win against Lincoln. The Mountain View beat Canby, they ain't stinking. They be running and gunning and picking up some yards. Madras running back, he's running so hard, I can't believe it. Throw to a receiver, kid, because next time you're gonna have to need it. And watch out, Tualatin came and beat Summit. But they'll be back, I know they ain't gonna plummet. It's KPOV 88.9.